Hi, welcome to the 11th chapter in Selenium using C Sharp. In this video, we are going to discuss about XPath access in Selenium WebDriver. This video is brought to you by AnkPro Training. Now let's see the agenda of this topic. What is an access? XPath access. There are many XPath access. The first one is parent. Second one is child, next following sibling, following, preceding sibling, preceding, ancestor and descendant. Let's see one by one in detail. This is a third video on XPath and there are remaining two videos on XPath in YouTube. You can check out that the XPath locator in Selenium WebDriver and XPath functions in Selenium WebDriver. Now let's focus on what is an access. An access stores certain information about an element. An access defines a node set relative to the current node. And it defines the tree relationship between the selected node and the current node. The information it stores depends on access being used. For example, an access called parent stores the information about the parent of the current element. Means here it defines the tree relationship between the parent and the one more element. We can use an access by using its name and target element. The syntax for an access, XPath access, is //tagName//access:// target element. For example, here I used //h1/parent:div. Here div and h1 is the tag names. Now let's see the first one, the first XPath access, that is XPath using parent filter. Parent filter select the parent element of the current element. Means the parent access contain the parent of the context node if there is one. And the syntax for this is //tagName//parent:// tag name. We used it in the program like driver.findElement by.XPath and we are passing the value inside the double quotes. Here I have used the h1/parent:// div. This XPath will select parent div element of h1 tag. Now let's move to the Chrome. In Chrome there is a CrowPath, that is an extension for Chrome browser. It is used to inspect and generate a XPath and CSS selector. Now I will navigate to the AnkPro page. See here, there is a CrowPath. Now I will show the how this CrowPath works. Here I am inspecting this AnkPro technologies that is present in H1 tag. And I will identify the parent of that element, H1 tag. For that, see how for the H1 tag it identifies the parent tag. The parent tag for this is div, it will give the content of that. Now let's use that in the program. I will copy paste first 4 lines and I will rename the method name as XPath access. Here I will do driver.findElement by.XPath in double quotes. I will copy paste that same thing and here I will use the property text. The return type of text is string, so that I will store that in a string variable. Now I will print that and I will give the thread.sleep inside that I will pass 3000 millisecond and I'm going to quit the browser. Now I will build this one. Now I will run this test case. See, it has launched the browser and it passed the URL and it will capture the text that is the parent of H1 tag. Now let's check the output. See, this is what we got the output. Here the parent axis contains the parent of the context node, that is H1 tag. Like this we will use the parent filter. The next one is XPath using child filter. The child filter select the child element of the current element. Means the child axis contains the child of the current node. The syntax is double forward slash tag name forward slash child colon colon tag name. We can use that in the program like driver dot find element by dot XPath of here. I am using a footer tag and I am identifying the child of that footer tag and I am giving the tag name here as P, and this XPath will select a child P element of footer tag. Now let's navigate to Chrome. Here I will paste that one. See, this is the footer tag. If I inspect this one, it is present inside the P tag. The P tag is the child tag of footer tag. Now let's move to the Visual Studio. I will copy paste this one. Control C. And I will comment these two lines. Here instead of that I will give. Now I will run the test case. See, it has launched the Firefox browser and it passes the URL. And it will capture the text that is present in the P tag, that is the child of the footer tag. Now let's check the output. See, this is the content present in the P tag. Like that, the child axis contains the child of the context node. Now let's move to the next axis, that is XPath using following sibling. The following sibling filter select all the sibling elements after the current element. The following axis contain all the nodes that come after the context node in document in order that excluding any of the context node descendants and also excluding attribute nodes and namespace nodes. The syntax for this is double forward slash tag name slash following sibling colon colon tag name. Here I used this in the code, that is driver dot find element by dot XPath. Here I have used the sixth row of the table and the following sibling colon colon tr. This XPath will select all tr elements of same parent after the sixth tr tag. That means that following axis contain all the nodes that come after the context node. Now let's move for Chrome. Here I will paste that following sibling. For that I need to traverse for the training page. Here I will paste that one. See, here I have given the sixth row. It will capture all the elements present after the sixth row. Like this we will use the following sibling. I am copying this XPath and I am moving to Visual Studio. Here first I need to change the URL. I will copy this line and I will paste here. And I am commenting these two lines. Here I am replacing the XPath with the following sibling axis. Here instead of this I will give a find elements and instead of text property here I will use a count property, and the return type for the count is int and I am printing that one. Now let's see what will be the output. Now let's it's run the test case. It has launched the Firefox and it will pass us the URL, and it will capture all the elements that are present in after the sixth row, and it will give the count of that. See here, there are six elements present after the sixth row. Like this, we will use the following sibling. Now let's see XPath using following axis. Following filter select all the element after the current element. Means the following contain all the nodes that comes after the context node in the document. The syntax for is double forward slash tag name forward slash following colon colon tag name. We can use it like driver dot find element by dot XPath and double forward slash tr of 6 I have given here, and I am giving the keyword following colon colon star. It will select all the nodes that comes after the context node. This XPath will select all elements after the 6th tr tag. Now I will move to this one here. Instead of following sibling, I will give only following colon colon star I will give. See, this will capture all the elements that is present after the 6th row. And I'm copying this one, and let's move to Visual Studio. I'm copy pasting these two lines and I'm commenting these two lines. Here instead of this, I'm going to give following colon colon star. Now I am running the test case. Now let's see. It will count how many elements present after the 6th row of different parent also. See, it has launched the browser, it passed the URL and it captured the count. Now let's check the output. See, there are 23 elements present after TR row. Like this, we will use following axis. The next one is XPath using preceding sibling. Preceding sibling filter select all the sibling element before the current element. This preceding axis contain all the nodes that are present before the tag. The syntax for this is double forward slash tag name forward slash preceding sibling colon colon tag name. We can be used in the program like driver dot find element by dot XPath double forward slash. Here also I am giving a 6th row and I am giving preceding sibling colon colon tr. This XPath will select all tr element of the same parent before 6th tr tag. Now let's move for Chrome. Here I am pasting that one. See, here I have given the 6th row. Here it has selected all the elements before the 6th row of same parent. Now let's move to Visual Studio. Again I am copy pasting these two lines. And I am commenting these two lines. Here instead of this, I am going to give the preceding sibling axis. And now let's run the test case. See, it has launched the browser and it will pass us the URL and it will capture the count. Now let's check the output. See, there are 5 elements present before the 6th row. Like this, we will use the preceding sibling. The next filter is XPath using preceding. Preceding filter selects all the element before the current element. The preceding axis contains all nodes that are before the current node in document order. The syntax for this is colon double forward slash tag name preceding colon colon tag name. Here same i6th row I used here. Instead of preceding sibling, I have given only preceding colon colon star. This XPath will select all element before the 6th tr tag. Now I am moving to Chrome browser. Here I am giving, see here, it will select all the elements of different parent also before the 6th row. Now let's move to the Visual Studio. Again I am copy pasting these two lines and I am commenting these two lines, and in XPath I am pasting this preceding colon colon star. Now I will run the test case. It has launched the browser. It will pass us the URL and it will capture the count of all elements present before the 6th row. Now let's check the output. See, there are 57 elements present at 6th row. Like this, we will use the preceding filter. The next one is XPath using ancestors. Ancestor filter select all ancestor, that is parent, grandparent, great grandparent, etc. of the current element. This ancestor axis contain all the ancestor of the context node, including its parents and grandparents and so on. This axis always contains the root node, unless the context node is a root node. It can be used like driver.findElement by.XPath. Here I am taking a table and I am giving an ancestor colon colon div. This XPath will select all parent div tags of table tag. Now let's move for Chrome. Here I will give that ancestor. See here, the table's ancestor it will identify. Like this, we will use the ancestor tag. Now let's move for Visual Studio. Again, I'm copy pasting these two lines and I'm commenting these two lines. I'm copying this XPath and I'm pasting here. Now let's run the test case. See, it has launched the browser and it will pass us the URL and it will capture the count of the ancestor. Now let's check the output. See, the ancestor count is 2. Like this, we will use the ancestor filter. The next one is XPath using descendant filter. The descendant filter select all descendant, that is children, grandchildren, great grandchildren, etc. of current element. We can be used like driver.findElement by.XPath. Here instead of ancestor, I am going to give the word descendant. This XPath will select all child TD tags of table tag. Now let's go for Chrome browser. Here I am pasting that. See, it will give the descendant of all the elements. Let's go back to the Visual Studio. Again, I am copy pasting these two lines and I am commenting these two lines. I am copying this and I am pasting that inside the XPath. And now let's run the test case. It has launched the browser and it will pass us the URL and it will capture how many elements present to that descendant of the tag. Now let's check the output. See, there are 24 elements. Like this, we will use the descendant filter. These are all the XPath axes. The possible interview questions on this topic are: which are the types of axes available in XPath? How to use parent filter in XPath? How to use child filter in XPath? How to use following and preceding sibling filters in XPath? How to use following and preceding filters in XPath? How to use ancestor filter in XPath? How to use descendant filter in XPath? Subscribe to our channel on YouTube, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and join our group on LinkedIn. And finally, don't forget to give your feedback in comment section. Thank you.